Good afternoon, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. An 81-year-old Keene man fought off a burglar inside his home early this morning. It all happened around 4:30 at a home on Eastern Avenue. Police say the suspect didn't get away with anything from the home, but they are still looking for him. The homeowner did suffer minor injuries in that scuffle. Meanwhile, Manchester police say they arrested the man who tried to rob the Fast Track convenience store on Willow Street last night. Police say 30-year-old Patrick Jones handed the clerk a note saying he was armed and wanted money. After another customer came into the store, he left empty-handed. Jones was stopped by police after an officer saw he matched the suspect description. A Nashua man is recovering after crashing his pickup truck into a sign pole along the Everett Turnpike in Nashua. The accident happened last night when state police say 33-year-old Jared Rossi was traveling at a high rate of speed in the left lane and then for an unknown reason veered across four lanes of travel and crashed through the guardrail, and his truck came to rest on its passenger side. Rossi suffered a broken hip. Police are also on the lookout for a group of young vandals who broke into the pump station at the McIntyre ski area in Manchester, causing thousands of dollars in damage. The teens tore through drawers in the shop, spray painted equipment, and sprayed the fire extinguishers into the chairlift terminals, all in broad daylight on Sunday afternoon. The damage is estimated to be about $20,000, and officials are asking anybody who recognizes the vandals to contact the Manchester Police Department. Well, the Red Sox maybe can clinch it at Fenway tomorrow night. The Sox lead 3-2 in the World Series after winning last night. Our live team coverage continues tomorrow from Fenway Park. Sports director Jamie Staton will have a preview of the crucial Game 6, and Gene Mackin will bring you the best of the Red Sox fans from outside the ballpark. Well, starting tonight at 5, word that Social Security may have paid out more than $1 billion extra to some recipients. Now those people are being told pay it back. And a controversial new trend has cropped up among military recruits. But does liposuction really help them meet the fitness requirements? That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.